this Mumbo's Math Tutorials, home of the best math tutorials.
In this lesson, we're going to read a postscript for similar triangles. So in the last lesson, we talked about polygons with different segments. Now we're going to focus more on the triangle and determine whether or not triangles are similar to one another. So, one of these things that we need is your protractor, and that's your straight edge. We're going to start by drawing two segments, one the label A, B, and the other one we're going to label A prime, B prime. We're going to make one segment noticeably bigger than the other. I'm measuring a 40 degree angle. We're not quite sure what angle to be 6 as it drops woods. It's a bit challenging to me on a small one. And the announcement to me is an angle, triangle, angle, sine, theon. But we make this angle 110 degrees. And this angle is 110 degrees. So you can see that all three angles are combined, all three angles are combined. Now what it would like us to do is it would like us to It does ask us if angle ACB, which is angle C, if angle ACB is equal to angle A prime, C prime, B prime, and it is indeed on the triangle angle sum. So now I'm going to take out my ruler, and you can use your ruler with some protractor, or maybe you have a ruler like I have, it's just a ruler. There are a couple of rulers up there now. C prime, B prime, C prime, so it's about 42. Yes, mm-hmm.
Times GO is equal to FG times KO.
how to think about things. How would you go about planning your course?
Well, in your course, so you can come up with an idea, draw it down, and we'll talk about it.
Okay, so what we have here is we have channels that are running angles, and we want to prove not the angle we are seeing in the posture. We want to prove that each hand turns GO, so suddenly each hand, which of the segment GO is equal to FG times KO. We can use the posture to prove this. This property of proportions that we're going to have to prove or get to. So we're going to start with the given information, either H and either alpha right angles that is given. And then we do know that either one or either two of the other angles and the angles are going to prove right. Now if I can prove that either H is equal to either F, I'm going to have two pairs of angles who run to one another, so that's where we're going to go next. I've only listed one pair of angles here. So we have one pair of angles, we're going to need another pair of angles. So we're going to go through this saying that angle H and angle F both have to equal 90 degrees because they're defined to be right angles. If they both equal 90 degrees, then you have to convert to each other. That's the definition of convert angles. And now, in my proof, since I've listed two angles, two pairs of angles are convert to one another, I can use the angle-angle similarity postulate to say that the two triangles are convert are similar. Now, very important how we line the triangles up. HKO, so I'm starting with the right angle, I'm going up the longer leg, and then down to parentheses O. So HKO, that's going to correspond to FGO, because HK is the longer leg of this right triangle, FG is the longer leg of the right triangle. These are going to correspond together. Correspond with one another. So I have HK corresponding to FG. So we're going to write in that order. Triangle HKO is similar to triangle FGO, or the angle similarity postulate. Now that I see that the two triangles are similar, I can go back based on the definition of similar polygons or similar figures, and I can create proportions. So the proportion that I want to create is going to involve HK, FG, KO, and GO. HK is to FG, so HK to FG is equal to KO to GO. That's corresponding sides of proportion in similar triangles. Step 7, which is our last step, we want to use the property of proportions. I like to say cross multiply, but that's the property of proportions. HK times GO is equal to FG times KO, which is your property of proportions. So, a little similar to the approach to congruent triangles, but not the same, because we're talking about similarity and not congruence. So we've got some other reasoning that we have to use here on our course. So you can kind of get an idea of what types of reasons we might be using to prove that two triangles are similar to one another. Now, in the practice problems, we're going to use the asymmetry postulate to line up triangles, put their corresponding sides together, work with their proportions, and use some mathematics in there to solve for unknowns. So I hope you found this video helpful, and good luck, and continue to do the practice problems.